Welcome back to Let's Play Enderal, Forgotten Stories, Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick. Our next mission, or quest, is to follow Jespar. Regardless of all hurdles and bizarre events, Constantine's plan worked out. We arrived on the Half-Moon Isle without anybody noticing. Now we have to hide the silver plates in the Nehrimese's camp. I have no idea how this is going to go. I'm not the best at sneaking. I'm in the 40s or something like that. And sneaking is 47, assisted by my gear, I guess, plus 2. Could be worse. I did put a bunch of points into it. We don't have any memory points, do we? Just want to double check. Otherwise, then I would put even more. Well, we have this. I guess I do have a memory point. Unlock tier 2. Oh. Stamina regeneration, yeah, boosted by 20%. Lets you move silently for a short period of time and raises your... Okay, so this would bring me up to 45 seconds. Almost double. And then what's this? Poisons, potions, and light armor. Now, I had to take this to start this tree, which I wanted to do, but I can put another point into it. What is this? Skill in sneaking, rhetoric, and sleight of hand. What's another one? Chance to be detected by enemies while sneaking reduced by 15%. Hmm. 15% or moving silently for longer. I think I'm going to take another tier in this. So this is now a skill. Or it's been a skill. I think I might leave Marius out of it. Because sometimes when I did... Well, you'd think Marius wouldn't be able to be detected, but I've seen him be detected sometimes. Alright. I'll try to leave... I'll see if I can leave him out of it this time. I don't know what this is going to be like. Old rail station. If Jespar is going to place one plate...
Seems someone is prepared a welcome for us.
I'll place the other. Guess there's more.
Now,
what?
Don't make it so easy.
Now I'm gonna collect all these steel arrows because I can sell them for a gold each, or a penny, whatever each. And you know what? This is going to take a while, but there's a bunch of them. Oh, that didn't seem to give me anything. Tiny though. Oh, it hurt me. I stayed too close to it. So when this is done, we shouldn't have any more bones around. I Still hurt me. Still too close. Well, it's not working if I'm hurting myself. First, the bonus to stop moving around. Oh, I think I know why. It's radiating from the center. And that's why it's hurting me. Did I get them all? Damn it. Well, I've like almost got it. I am more healed than I was. It's not up to full like I would like. Let's see if there's anything interesting around here, like ice claws or anything like that. I'm on the train. Cool. So really, identical to the other rail station, except more wrecked. Da-da-da. Just taking a look around, Jespar. So we're going that way. No, there's nothing around here. Half Moon Isle. You sneak faster than I do. Already I'm detected by something. Panthers? Feline cat pelts. There we go. Now I'm full. According to this, I'm on the farmer's coast. How's that possible? Jespar is hurt. Birdie of Doom.
All right.
It's Should I be looking around for, like, stuff? Ice claws and things? Now, granted, I might be able to be seen because of the light in my hands, but we're not by any enemies yet other than panthers. Is that undead over there? I think so. He won't help me with that. I mean, we might be headed there for all I know. I'm not sure where this road goes. Oh, where our path leads, actually. Off the road at some point. We're not going that way? Well, I'm gonna... see if I can take care of this.
What?
Oh, he is helping. Oh, that did hurt me. Yay! Cheap health potion, potion of might. Yeah, I'll take them all. Oh, I like the steam. Oh, I did see that. 27 coins. Wonder what else might be around here, you know? It's not like I can get a map in the of the area. It still thinks... yeah, I'm by Farmer's Throne. I've been to Farmer's Throne and this is not it. Definitely not. I don't think he's sneaking. Was he ever sneaking? Or he had his, he just has his weapon out. There's another panther over there.
Well, I'll be damned. This is Half Moon Isle. I can't believe it. And I guess that camp over there belongs to Terranor Korak. I suggest we split up. That way we'll still have a chance if they catch one of us. Here,
this
is your
plate. Split up.
I'll try going in from the east. You should go in from the west. And don't get caught or try to play the hero, all right? Considering that we're up against an entire army, that's a bad idea, even for someone with your abilities.
Yeah, where would be a good place to put my plate?
Anywhere inside the camp. But of course an officer's tent, or maybe even Korak's, would be ideal.
Ah. Korak's. Of course I have to try. I know that's going to be pushing it, though. Understood. Let's go, then.
We'll meet again here by sunrise.
Position the silver plate in the Nehrimese encampment. Gotta try, you know. Actually. Well, that was easy. Did you say I should go from the west? Or into... I think he said from the west. Which, I should go that way then. But I don't think this is leading into the camp. Unless I do have some stuff around here that I can collect. I'm just gonna take a look down here. Looks like a camp fortification here. Move silently. Get in there, that requires a key. What's this plate look like? There it is. Clutter. I'm supposed to be planting this somewhere. Alright. He said from the west, so he... I think he headed off this way. So maybe it's not from the west after all. That's to the west, anyway. Alright, I'm going this way.
And if they refuse,
then it means war. The gods have befouled the world with their ignorance long enough.
You know, that would mean the deaths of thousands of innocents.
No idolizer is ever innocent. Religions are ideologies, and an ideology is a decision. Subjects who don't rebel against their tyrants are at least as guilty as the tyrants themselves. But let's see what's going to happen. Who knows? Maybe that old fool Aranthial will listen to reason.
Huh.
For once in his life.
Yeah, let's see.
I don't know if you guys can hear this. Hear that. I don't know if it's them that keeps, like... seeing me for a second? Or something else, like a mud crab or something. thought I heard a spirit for a second. I do hear it. I hope this doesn't make noise to where people can hear it. There it is. Eterna Ambassador 4. Nice. That's a level 4 enchantment. And I guess that's her, or was her. I wonder if I can It wouldn't make sense, right? Did I get anything? It actually would not make sense since I have the soul. How can I also devour the soul? Unless it's disappeared from my inventory. I have that. Eterna Ambassador. That's awesome. Level 4 soul. And I'm pretty sure Marius is a level 2. I haven't gotten around to this because it's also 2. 2 and 2. I need to get enchanting to 75 though. That's a... Ooh. That's going to be difficult. Something to work towards. I'm almost done with entropy, though. Entropy is friggin' hard as hell. And rhetoric. Entropy. Well, I do need some more. Sneak's at 47, rhetoric is at 86. This guy's tent is. Recharge 60, 60? Is that 60 seconds or 60 minutes? Is that a living thing or a dead thing? I think that's dead. But the spider is alive. I'll poison it with its own venom. Or not.
Oh. The urchin child who just won't stop struggling.
It's a high one? First a dream, now these animals. Why the puppet play? Afraid of talking to me face to face?
Afraid?
Yeah, no, probably not.
You amuse us, you know.
I do.
How you refuse to give up.
That's another one.
How you keep on fighting, even though deep down you know your struggle is futile. But still, you have come a long way. You have ignited the sigil stone, and you have found the beacon. And this urchin child, this amuses us.
Okay.
Because nothing is more entertaining than a harvest which fights back.
A harvest?
It makes things so much more exciting. So here's our offer, Prophetess.
An offer?
Ask us whatever is on your mind, and we swear to answer truthfully. Or you can leave. It's up to you.
Is there a catch? Well then, let's start with the question of why I should believe, for even a second, that you're going to tell me the truth.
As you wish. You had a choice, and forgive us for the pain.
The pain?
Now!
What? Oh, so much for getting in stealthily.
My lord, she is awake.
Splendid.
Correct.
May I introduce you? To your left, there's Samael, my bodyguard, master of Ostian's arena for decades.
I can't see
and
to my
to
left.
To your right, there's Blademaster Alma Sordan, the most gifted sword fighter of Nehrim's North and commander of my troops.
I can't see the
Furthermore,
right either.
There's an entire garrison of elite soldiers outside.
Oh, good.
So, can I trust you to not do anything stupid? I want to talk to you, face to face, as civilized people do.
I can't see your face. I just love civilized people, especially when they start conversations by knocking someone down, tying him up, and blindfolding him.
Fair point. But you forgot to mention that this particular someone tried to sneak into my camp. I think we are square.
No, I was talking to the high ones.
By the way, we have captured your friend as well. He's in a tent up in the camp, and we will compare your stories, so you'd better stick to the truth.
Can I believe
Samael,
him?
Samael, take off the blindfold.
Oh, that would be a good idea. Now I can see to my left and
well,
right
then,
and stuff.
I am Taranor of Korex Blood, former ruler of Kabyat, and now representative of the Free Peoples of Nerim, which you undoubtedly already knew. Who are you?
Nice emblem. The Free Peoples of Nerim?
That is who we are, yes. The civil war is over, and Nehrim is once again united, free of tyranny and false gods. We don't follow a monarch anymore, and we do not pray to any idols, unlike people in this country. But we digress. Who are you?
Serta Summerstone? That's the daughter of that guy who attacked the merchants? I don't know why I specifically say that. I don't want to get her in trouble or implicate her. They have them, like, try to hunt her down, so I'm not going to lie. I would lie and make up a name, but I'm not going to, yeah, get her in trouble. I'm Topaz.
I see. And who sent you? And why?
Why all the questions? Aren't you just going to kill me anyway?
Actually, no, I won't. Contrary to what you might believe, I am no butcher, and I don't kill for the fun of it.
Butcher?
And even though I cannot guarantee you will survive this night, I promise that cooperation will increase your chances drastically. So, who sent you?
So you're not going to kill me, but you can't guarantee I'll survive this night. No one. We're just scroungers.
Are you now? Odd place to go looking for treasure?
Yeah, well...
I don't...
My lord, I think you should see this.
Of course. We have taken the liberty of stripping you of your belongings.
Hey.
If you'll excuse me for a moment, please.
Well, I can't look at my inventory. Nice boobs.
A silver plate. You're a spy.
Oh, that's for eating off of.
You know, only a stupid lamb lies to the wolf's face. Don't say I didn't warn you. Samael, perform your duty.
Which one's Samael? What are you gonna do now? Oh! You... Ah! You killed me? He killed me! Alright. Guess we can't lie. What did he do? It looked like he pinched me. To death.
Can I trust you to not do anything stupid? Fair point. By the way, Samael, take off the blindfold.
Samael.
Well then, I am Taranor of Corex. That is who we are, yes. We don't follow a monarch anymore, and we... I see. And who sent you? Actually, no. And even though I cannot guarantee you will survive this night, I promise that cooperation will increase your chances drastically. So, who sent you?
Well, let's just say I had a future vision, in which case if I say that we're nobody, just scroungers, Samael there, a pinch me to death. So I'm going to sigh and say the Holy Order. They want to know why you're here.
Just as I suspected. And how exactly...
My lord, I think you should see this.
Of course. We have taken the liberty of stripping you of your belongings. If you'll excuse me for a moment, please.
Okay, so hopefully now Samael does not pinch me.
A silver plate. I see. They were sent to spy on us.
Then let's kill them.
Whoa!
No. She was honest, and I am a man of my word. And actually... Actually, you have done us a favor. We can use the plates to present Aranthiel with our offer, without putting ourselves in danger.
We'll just voluntarily use them.
What? How? What are these plates?
Old artifacts of the Pyreans. Their magic works like a sort of ear conch. Sounds are transferred from one plate to the other.
Ear conch.
And I strongly suspect that at this very moment, Taelor Aranthiel and Narathzel's traitorous heirs are gathered around the counterpart, waiting for someone to activate this plate, aren't they? Samael, do you know how to use these plates? Excellent.
Isn't talk?
Then activate it. I will talk to old Aranthiel. Let's hope that he will listen for once in his life. Otherwise, this will end in disaster.
Definitely did not turn out how I thought it would.
Taelor Aranthiel. I know that you are there and that you can hear me. So why don't we just stop playing games?
Can he hear... speak back?
As you wish, Grandmaster. You can keep quiet, but you should be aware of who's going to pay for your arrogance.
I don't know if he can talk back through that thing.
Haven't you had enough war by now? After 2 decades.
2 decades of war that were necessary, because your gods suppressed the people. Or would you deny even this?
Is that why you wanted to talk to me, Quarek? To throw around accusations?
No, that's not what I wanted. We are talking because I want to give you a chance.
A chance?
We know that you are fighting the High Ones, and that you're trying to reconstruct the beacon in order to stop them.
Which makes perfect sense, since the cleansing means the end of all life. Don't you agree?
No, I don't. And if you even remotely understood who the High Ones actually are, and what they represent, you wouldn't either.
What?
They are evolution, the ascendance of humanity to a higher level.
We...
What?
Can't evolve if we're dead.
Let's just face the facts for a moment. There's no evidence that the cleansing, whatever shape it will take, will be violent. Yes, the Pyreans are gone, but how do we know they've not just simply gone to another place? That they've transformed?
I doubt that.
The High Ones are not our enemies, Aranthiel. They are the next step of evolution, the envoys of our purpose, that we might become more than the simple-minded creatures we've been during the past millennia.
They seem pretty malevolent.
This is what the cleansing actually is. Don't you understand? It's the moment when humanity is relieved of its vices, united, reaching a higher level of existence.
You... That's absurd.
Yeah, really.
To you, it might sound that way, but I have seen it with my own eyes. Ever since the gods departed, the High Ones have sent me dreams in which I can see the future, and it's glorious. It's not our destiny to stay human, Aranthiel. With their help, we will be gods, true gods, not the idols you have worshipped. It's the truth, whether you accept it or not.
No, it doesn't work that way.
People are dying, Kuarik. There's war all over Veen. The dead are rising from their graves, and people are killing each other for no apparent reason. Whatever you have dreamed, does this look like some kind of ascension to you?
I know about the Red Madness, but has it ever occurred to you that it follows a pattern as well? That it only befalls certain people?
Whom?
People whose thinking is in shackles. People whose minds are not free, and who are superstitious and ignorant. Such as the people in your country, to whom you have denied the truth about their gods.
What? Are you saying that the Red Madness only affects religious people? People who still believe in the Lightborn?
It's pretty much everyone in this continent, though.
Religiosity is a pattern of thought that favors irrationality over reason. Someone who thinks in these patterns is simply not ready for the advancement, and the Red Madness is simply a way to sieve them out. A natural selection, if you will. That's also why you are not affected by it, Aranthiel. Because you know that what you and your order fought so hard to keep up over the years were lies.
This is nonsense. There have been cases of Red Madness in the Order, too. And we have seen what the cleansing will bring us in the dreams and in their chronicles. And it has nothing to do with some kind of ascension.
Yeah, tell him.
Just listen to yourself, Kuarik. You talk like a mad prophet. Is that what you want to be?
You react just as I expected. Very well, then. Will you at least hear our offer?
Speak.
The cleansing has to happen, and we, the free peoples of Nehrim, will make sure that it does.
That's no offer.
We will not allow your backward thinking to keep humanity from advancing, as it has done for centuries. Therefore, if you don't want a war, you will stop rebuilding the beacon, and you will tell your people the truth about their gods, so that then they, too, can ascend when the time has come.
It wouldn't even work that
You've
way.
You've said it yourself, Aranthiel. This world has had enough war. Spare it yet another one.
I would if I could. But if these are your demands, then no.
Yeah, death is not a good.
Then we will have to force you. This means bloodshed, Aranthiel, and innocents will die, and all because...
This conversation is over.
Yeah, that went well.
Bloody fool.
Yeah, you sure are.
Alma, prepare the attack. He asked for it.
Yes, my lord. What will happen to the prisoners?
The spies. Right. We're at war now, and this means you're my enemies. But as I said, I am a man of my word, and so I'll leave your fate to chance. Samael, put her to sleep, and then put her and her friend on a raft. If they survive, so be it. If not, fair enough.
You're gonna put me on a raft? Samael, you stay away from me. I don't want to be pinched by you. Samael, he's pinching me.